it's going.
This is Haikocha. This is my older version when I was trying to just make it for myself.
Now, in the interest of
exploring
your game mechanics,
you
I'm going to scout little turtles.
So yeah. I'm going to be explaining these as turtles. They don't look anything like turtles. So this is the tortoise, the one with the rough edges around that. Everybody has three tortoises.
Okay.
They are the strongest piece that we have. They are able to push another piece exactly two spaces. So
I have two tortoises, so they are all these the best pieces.
Yeah. So this piece here would be able to push this one 1, 2, or if it was 1, 2. And there'll be a lot of spots where you can't. I'm not able to push it there and do 1, 2 and push it in the other. I can't jump anything.
Okay.
I can't scooch anybody.
Okay.
You're using one piece to move another piece.
Okay.
The tortoise always moves something else too.
Super bonus, you become
is not able to push anybody, but it's extremely valuable when you start getting it over into your scoring area. So,
okay,
blue player,
so
my scoring
area
is where all these ones are, and I'm going to have to get myself over there and then start spreading them out of my way so that I can get into this triangle that matches the pattern that you see over there. So you've got just one line going over to one line, double line going to double line, solid going to solid.
Okay.
The farthest central one there is 7 points, and then there's 5 and 5 on either side of it.
I got
if you're familiar with the phone form Haiku, that's where the name Haiku, or the part of the name, is coming from.
Okay.
So there's 5, 7, 5 in the back, and then these ones are 3 and 3, and then this spot is only worth 1.
Okay.
And I'm pointing at the pieces, but it's really those spots.
Yeah.
And then the egg is super valuable. It will triple whatever it lands on. So if you get over to the 7, 7 times 3 is 21.
Okay.
So that is the best place to start getting that egg. The
any number
turtle here is going to just double.
Okay.
So if it gets over there, then that's 14.
These are
going to
have, I'm pretty sure.
That's 2.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's
yep.
And the tortoise
is exact.
Is just single exact.
Yep.
Yes.
Whenever somebody gets
and,
a fifth
okay,
piece
and then part of what that is, so
their scoring area.
So,
so you're only
like
going to be
able
to get 5 of your
pieces like in where
there
they have
before the game
up, like what the, that's
you'll get
where
all
they're
six.
Going to be attacked. So
but
we all know, that we're going
to
get one thing on this
piece
side.
In there.
So
like if my piece gets close
like
here,
two swords.
Then he might be like, well, I'm going to push you
1,
and then whenever it gets
all
there and it's in this triangle, it flips over and it no longer moves.
I think it's we get like these guys.
So now,
but then there's also going to be
2
more attacks, I'm pretty sure.
You know, because 3 times 1, it's never going to make it in there and be worth 21 and something. So to get that, you're going to have to go here first and then go over 2. So how to do that.
Okay.
And then whenever it flips over and it's in the center, or it's in the scoring triangle, it's still able to push other things, it just cannot be pushed.
Okay. Okay.
So it's an immovable object.
It's an immovable object that is able to push. Do you feel like playing, or do
sure.
you want to? I can scoot over and you can take a spot for playing, and then I can facilitate a little better.
So we break all of Newton's laws.
So these are
yes.
So one. So that one's
so what
okay.
we've got is 3 different piece types. These are your tortoises. They're the strongest.
Yeah.
They push another piece exactly.
Does it
spaces.
Matter the fact that
so if this one's like out of the
so,
way, then this tortoise could push
my
this one
gate
1, 2.
What this way and to
the
him
turtles push
is facing
one,
the other
way.
So we have them in different
one,
orientations.
One
is that
here, one
matter?
There. Doesn't matter which direction it goes. Push this one 1. And the egg is the most valuable, but it's not able to push anything at all. It
okay.
just can
well,
be
but
pushed.
It kind of does because, like,
when
for you,
you
you're going to get attacked to
this
gate,
scoring
and
area,
for me, I'm going to get attacked on my wall.
The
yeah.
score
yeah.
is going to be 5, 7, 5, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, and this
okay.
doubles whatever
that makes
it means,
sense.
And this is just singles.
And
okay.
you've done things,
and whenever it ends up in this scoring triangle, it flips over. is able to move other things, but it can no longer be moved. So if you get this one to here, you're not going to be able to move it over there and get the 21 points. It's going to be stuck there and be So it gives you some motivation to push somebody else's piece real quick into their scoring area and be like, sweet, you made the points, but now you're not going to be able to make as many points.
I spent 15 and then I took
3 and you just gotta have somebody go left so you can see them and be like, doing here. So you like start us out.
Is there any rules for where you can push things? So if
so
this guy's here, can you push this guy this way? Or if this so if this wasn't here, he could push this guy any direction. It doesn't just have to be away.
Yep.
Okay. Okay.
Exactly. And another thing I don't think I mentioned.
No, it's my turn.
But the moves that you do have to involve your piece. Does that make sense? One of your pieces. So you can push yourself, or you can push somebody else, or you can use somebody else to push yours. But if I'm the blue player, I couldn't do this because I'm not involved over here. That's not my
thing.
So all of these pieces you can use to move yourself, or you can move them to get them. You're going to have to move them to get them out of your way. But you have to be involved.
The torch is everything have to be line of sight, or can it be like
straight line? So you can't do like here from this one moving that. It has to, you have to move other things out of the way first.
Yeah, sometimes it can be really
and the game will end whenever anybody gets five of their pieces into their scoring area. So this is your scoring area. So you go from the solid lines to the solid lines.
Okay.
Cool.
I'm going to use this guy to push this guy.
Cool.
Okay, so now, take one food, which is the yellow cube, for each of your active farms, or two food,
it doesn't move by, none of them move by themselves, they just push something else, and this one has no pushing ability. It's in the new art, which you buy, it's
an
egg,
peons
and it's a little easier for people to turn off that, okay, an egg doesn't push anything, but a big, strong tortoise.
Yeah,
upside down. Nice. Okay. Well, I'll just push this guy.
Wild man?
So I'm going to use this guy to push this guy.
Yep.
The tortoise will push
then
this.
Then lose one
food
for each PR. So essentially, most of us would have gained four and lost three.
And it has to be in a straight line.
Your attack last turn, decide which wall to put your troops to best defend your city. There is one faced-up invader column showing a gold level and how many invaders of what
push
type
this guy, push
it
this guy.
Would place. If you meet the gold level,
so I can use the other pieces to push my own guys, correct?
On the far land indicated by the red border, north, south, east, west,
move
the same for your board as the countryside. If this isn't helpful, you will spread your troops.
Yeah, with your own pieces. But that you could say
general showing for the audience and such.
Remember that if you have any corner turrets, they will shoot invaders in each adjacent farmland. Troops do not go to the corners or turrets.
And there's one rule I haven't gone into yet, but I'm going to get into it when it gets close to actually coming into play.
Yes.
All right, so I'm going to use this guy, push this guy.
Oh, and this is where that comes into play. So now, you've pushed him. And if he wants to move back to this space, you can't push him again and like keep going
back and forth and back and forth. Okay, yeah.
So you're trying to bully him. If he decides to stand up for himself and on his turn come back, then you can't.
How do you?
So you have the ability with this to just go right back.
No, I get that. That's why my question is how do you do that? Then, the other
just remember what
well, it's the same as like in chess, you know.
Remember,
what do they call it?
Invader cards have a random orientation, so don't fix them.
Yeah, it's the one you do three moves in a row. If it's the exact same three moves for it, and then it's a draw. Yeah, it's just like the same thing.
Or 50 moves, no pawn or anything's taken. Draw.
Yeah. But this is just like, if I move, or it's like in go.
Yeah.
Yep. I get it.
So we're always flipping.
There was a way to flip.
I'll use this tortoise to
move
the turtle over two spaces.
Do it all the same.
Okay, so.
Oh. Okay, so you pushed it with this one?
Yeah.
Yes. Almost.
Oh,
you lucked out.
No. Oh, that one. It just can't be like if it's.
What about
do
this?
A ding ding kind of thing?
It doesn't say that yet, so let's make it up. Okay, and so then I can, and then since I scout, I can now.
Yes, like this guy can push this guy to two.
You can't curve a bullet.
Screw you.
Okay.
That so everyone needs two close range. Two close range.
Yeah, you can put them.
No, I know what I'm thinking.
Gamecrafter? What's that?
Yeah.
How do you, does that like
there's
Gamecrafter.
Yeah.
Prototype.
Yeah. Basically all the cards, chips for the Gamecrafter and all the boards.
I'm going to use this guy to push this guy right there.
So
you're right.
Yeah.
My bad.
I forgot about that.
That makes sense. I was going to say, because I felt a little bit broken. All right.
Wait,
I'm going to
watch each player complete combat in player order, skip players without waivers. Remember, if a troop other than a mercenary is killed, put the red dagger on the blacksmith as a covered weapon. Or if you have a surgeon, put the red cube on that card to the cheese. Okay, so, first, raise farms in farmlands with invaders. Raise two or more if you have a down wall. How would you...
Hi, folks. How's it going?
So, are you here for the uncut? All of us have that one raised. Repeat. Wait, what? These three steps. Repeat these. So A, raise the farms. B, repeat these three steps until all invaders are killed. They're your city's set.
I think it says repeat these four steps.
These
three steps. No, not the above steps. Yes, just like, because I was thinking it's the above. Okay, so archery invaders, black circles with bow, in a farmland, each kill one troop in the nearest wall, and each wall troop kills one invader in the nearest farmland. Each wall troop, the one in each wood corner troop kills one invader in the
nearest farmland.
We don't have any archery dudes. We got all sorts of men.
Yes.
So each of our dudes shoot them.
Was there a difference of me putting, like, when I put them on the field? Was that a difference, or did I just not understand?
They're just going to die. So we just shot them. They didn't do anything. Right? Because they're not archery dudes. They're just swords.
Sure. All my troops are on the field.
So it's a little interesting because like these, as far as I recall, are like strength. They're like hit points. Whereas your red loops are actually dudes. So it's like right now we're all filled up, and then these are like auto-firing. They don't need dudes inside them. So you get one automatic.
So you can't switch it with this, but it would have to go exactly two spaces.
Okay, let's
go.
Really cool. Totally. They made it super hard. Yeah, I thought.
Little kids into it. He's a good tester.
They're all
really
good. Nice.
Yeah, I'll go take a glass.
Farmland invaders each remove one defense cube from the nearest wall. Goes away. Place remove cubes in your stockpile. Inside the city, each invader kills one troop, and each troop kills one invader.
Use this guy.
Yeah, so you still have a wall, but then it doesn't have any... Okay, hold on.
damage rolls until no defense claims remain. Troop and advanced insights do damage each other. So they're going to damage the wall.
So they damage the
this
wall.
There's no
damage.
This guy's on it. Yeah. And then I think your attack is going to go inside because there's no 150 left.
Yeah.
Not your troop attack. Yeah. But I think you're going to
spot one. Well, and each troop heals one invader, so I guess you could have left, you could leave.
I just need that.
Okay, let's, then if there are any invaders but no troops inside your city, you are sacked and lose
I'm gonna use this
any leftover coward troops and skip to IIIC. Cowards aren't killed, instead run with their weapons, thus you will not put red cubes on the servant blacksmith. They all lost. Yeah, you have a... Wait, you did kill him? How'd you kill him?
Is that how that works?
Well, but then, okay, so then your troop dies. Because each invader kills one troop, and each troop kills one invader. No, I don't think you did. I don't think you did. I think that guy got inside, and because there was no...
Can we just read it in order?
Yeah, I did.
So we read it the first time. Where they did range guys did their
thing. Okay.
And then
the bad guys did their thing.
And then we went through the whole list and nothing else happened.
It's like chess,
and
it's a game, it's complex and stuff. I'm not the best.
Oh, yeah, we haven't been moving yet, so... Okay. Okay, here we go. I need to, yeah, we should have read
archery
all this.
Happens, then melee.
Then
damage
movement. So damage. Okay, then movement. Primarily invaders move inside the city if the nearest wall is down, has no defensive cubes. You may move your troops from a wall to an adjacent wall or inside the city, or from inside the city to any wall. Move enough troops inside the city to kill any invaders the next round. If any invaders remain, except A, B, and C. Okay, so yeah. And then he goes inside. They both die.
Well, do we do archery first?
He's not an archer, and... Yes, he's an archer. In the nearest farmland, so no.
Do we all have one dude, one of our tortoises, in their original place?
Yes.
Yes.
And your cube goes onto your blacksmith as a weapon. You can cover the weapons. Okay. And so we're not sound.
And your last cube, you put your stockpile. Yeah.
Okay. So no one is sacked. If the invader took a hostage, no one did. Okay. You may heal two troops inside your city if you have the surgeon. If your goal marker fell below 25 or 15 gold spots, you must replace.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
Must replace your fifth and
fourth
heal
of
one
yeah,
mark.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna use this guy to make this guy one.
So, new turn. We start.
Oh, is that not his?
Oh, yes. Okay, so...
Oh, he's trying to go over there. Sorry, I thought he was...
First?
Oh, okay, because we're...
Yeah, so you're not...
So, yeah, I'm moving it. I'm using him.
Oh, nice.
That's the worst, yes. I just
misread
where he was trying to go.
I think we ignored in the learning game.
So in a two-player, are you going...
We ignored
in
the
learning game,
but usually I'll play with somebody here, somebody here.
I would assume so.
Yeah, and then...
Stick up, face up under.
Face up under here.
Try not to stack them
the
same
direction.
Well, I figure when we get to this point,
if you play two players and straight across,
doesn't matter.
The side pieces kind
of
just get
ignored. Well, only that it takes a certain amount of shuffling to get them on the same direction.
Really, six-player game and everyone just free for all.
It's a little bit. You got to get good at your talent. But I don't think we're gonna. If we're definitely not in four seasons, we're not gonna get to the end of this. In fact, let's see how many are there. How many of these are there?
Probably not. Now I see what you're doing. So you're just being a jerk.
I will,
nope! I wanted to get my guy moving.
Use my torch to shove this guy up 2 spaces.
27.
So those are base
guys. So there's 10. So this goes up to 10. Okay, anyways. So. 1, 2,
except for.
Well.
Flip it this way.
Yeah.
We gotta be consistent as long as we do it.
Yeah. Okay. So, go first.
It's in the
robot. I
can use this guy.
Alright, so yeah, now we reassess the turnover.
Yes, so turnover, I think, has been reset. No, I'm last.
Oh, wow.
Yes, so it's no, it's going to be. Sorry, I'm upside down. So, yeah. So, red, green,
gray,
yellow. Yes. Okay, so your turn.
Yeah, good to see you.
Yes. Okay, hold on. Now we've got to go back because. Okay, to start, place the season tracker. So, season tracker goes up one. Repair. They place one defense cube from your stockpile to fill your walls or turrets. Take 5 gold on the gold tracker at the bottom of your pantry sideboard.
Go check it.
And except for green, you get 6.
I'll show it to Mortis off shield.
Okay, you take 6. If you hit, you know, hit 15, so it doesn't matter. Place the invader cards.
Taxes. Or whatever. Which is always good. I get 6, though.
Get the trade. Okay, so to repair the farms, that's the farms down there.
Yeah.
So it flips it over, and then you get the 1 food.
You get 1 farm?
No, yeah, that's an action.
That's an action. Okay,
okay, so yeah.
Horseman.
Oh, this guy.
Yeah, so there are 2 of the. They are special invaders.
Would defense cube plus if Torchman do not clear your stockpile as you do? That makes sense. If any Torchman sacks you, place 1 damage token. Random.
That's an interesting
so this one's got to repair 1, so I'd have to put 3
down. No, I'm in jail.
If I get 7.
Yeah,
it looks like red, you can start.
Mostly
board games
or
hands-on. Yeah, we have to sit there.
Like, I like games that are so simple that all the tactics comes down to the relationship between the players rather than, you know, dice rolls or something like that. So, yeah.
Well, it says it in the beginning. Right? So, at the beginning of your turn.
Oh, right.
I'll move your egg back.
So, I don't think you do sleeping for your. If it's at the beginning of the turn after the 5 gold. No.
Would you go?
Yeah. But at the beginning of your turn after you get the 5 gold, if it's over the 15.
Well, you can just shove it right back up.
During your
turn,
you don't
can't
get it
back
until the next
turn.
You push me.
2
off here, yeah.
This is that guy right there. Yeah.
So basically, you can think of it as.
I want
move,
iron.
The 6
things that can make me weapons.
Around it are the options
iron.
It has.
Or the other way around.
Got it.
Like, this is the piece that I can move with.
Yeah,
and this is that I want.
So it's my go?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And they have parts.
Alright, I'm going to use this guy. Push this guy over here.
Not quite
in
the
scoring
chart.
Not yet.
How do we get these guys on?
All the eggs are
created
in the building
right
now.
They're kind of the core of the game. So you place things there to get.
Yeah, in the back.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And they have cost. Yeah, it costs 4
food
and
then
you
can
see that you can pay
a
cost. Yeah,
that's
cost.
I'm going to blacksmith to turn my iron into weapons.
4 minute
walks. Awesome.
I can totally imagine you doing a drag with using
this
yet.
Oh, I just put that there for now. I guess we're close.
Nice to keep everybody small.
Let's make some flippers.
I'm kind of happy about that. I did not have to go with that.
What's your go?
We could really scoot it somewhere else or something, but they're not.
But we're having like tons of fun.
Okay.
Alright.
I will,
So,
I'll use this to show support to you. games of strategy. Pure strategy. I'm not good at them. What strategy for the law? I'm not good at them. It has to have just like that little combat.
Yeah, that's good. My dad is my mom.
Okay, wait. I'm going to do something interesting, and I think I'm going to need you to
you what?
Tell me whether or not this is legal.
This is a tortoise, right? Or is that an egg? I'm going to use this guy here to push this guy.
They just get stupidly fast.
Stupidly fast. A lot of stupid. That's not there yet.
It's got to be touching.
It's that one. I thought it was.
So it's
fast.
These three right here.
Yeah. Is that triangle?
That's, at least I think that's
so see the three design marks there?
Yes,
if you're touching one of those, then you're in the thing.
So it's all of those triangles.
Wait a minute. How are you?
That's where I'm trying to go. He's trying to go to these. You're trying to go to these.
This one here, the turtle, is worth double.
Okay,
and these are single. And then 5, 7, 5.
I got some.
Get 21 points by getting your head.
Okay, I might be cheating here, but so Mason lets me buy anything with two less. So I'm going to take this guy and go to build the fences. I'm going to build.
Move this up.
Stone defense. For four, but then do I get the 5 tokens or just the 4?
This is just depends on if it's your gear.
Yeah, but I only spent 4. So do I still get the 5?
Yeah, you're not replacing your gear. You're replacing your gear. So you're gonna get the 5.
Okay.
At least that's how I enter. That seems pretty clear.
Okay.
I feel like it probably is written somewhere, but... Well, wood, wall, slash gates, and the wall is 2.
But then cost, and then... I don't know.
It says when you build a city defense, it comes filled with food.
Oh, okay. Well, so technically, now, if the invaders were to knock down this wall, I would get 5 of them back for spending 4. So technically, I could use this as an infinite wall.
Your mason is just really good. No matter
what.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean, I've got gold elves
in the other room.
Okay. So, and then it's going to be, and then... That should also probably, the turn order should also probably be on the cards.
So it's on the board.
Oh. Oh, it is.
So we did prepare, so now we get to... Oh, so now we're to allocate. Yeah. So now we're to harvest.
This guy.
One per field.
Push this guy.
So I'm going to harvest 3.
I got a real quick question.
Yeah,
if I push something through the squad,
now we allocate.
But you can charge.
You could, like, hop over.
We allocate.
Oh, yeah.
So it does not get stuck in
this.
Yeah,
if you land in there, then it turns over.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. I will, shove the
and then the dwarf inside, you should probably remember, is going to get burned down if you don't shoot this
room. Alright, so we're going to reveal. So it looks like we're supposed to reveal them this way, but we'll just be consistent with the way we're doing it.
Okay. Or spin.
But it's not really necessary. Press the
pause. Yeah, strikers.
Okay, so
I guess
we got two
special. Yeah, if you guys want to pause the game here, we'll do it later so you can
sure. Yeah, just tell me what you think so far.
Yeah, it's
haven't got to the scoring part yet.
Yeah, it's pretty interesting.
You like it?
Yeah,
I like how simple everything is. And how.
No, go ahead, sorry.
You can kind of block people, but you can't really block people. And if you block people, you're blocking yourself.
Yeah.
So then. Trying to get yourself through, you usually make openings for other people, which
okay.
makes a very organic
so,
growing of the game.
Let's raise
so
our
that,
bar.
Right, how I did the
so
little move over here allowed him to just
come
back through this
yeah.
way. So that is a really cool natural aspect of the game. And the different scoring over here is already making me try and think, oh, how am I going to get that egg to that maximum point? Because it's like, if you get the egg there, and the
so
other person, another person
sure
gets
though,
the eggs
these
the front,
are neither,
it's like,
these are technically neither,
it doesn't really matter how anything
so
else in there
is
like, you're basically,
you're
maybe,
no,
maybe
no,
not
no,
already
no,
one,
no,
but maybe not for
count.
Sure one,
oh,
but
yeah,
if you,
because it's,
they'd have to do way really good
I mean,
and you'd have to do pretty bad on the rest of it in order for you to lose,
I don't see that in it's not like,
but yeah, so that's really cool, and then with,
black circle with bow,
so like you can worry about, just not worry about getting your, I like how you can not have to worry about which order you get them in there, just try and get as many in as you can as quick and not have anyone else in, and then you win because you know, you've got points and no one else has any points. Or you could try and take some more time and get those, like, this guy in perfect and this guy in perfect and this guy in perfect, which gets the maximum number of points, but someone might win before
you,
so it's got that classic, you know, early, mid, and late game strat, which is really cool.
Well, yeah, like, I'm trying to remember, I played a game that
Doris
had just,
way. Well, in this game,
oh, no, it
way,
was, small boy. Small
melee, does anyone have any melee moves left?
Everything you do will
I think,
affect someone
I think
somehow.
Most of us have, melee moves.
Most of the time, that's
back.
Good or bad for
oh.
all of you. Also, I like to find this.
I
know
their turn. I know their turn. Okay, so
often, it's mainly just two or four players.
So they're going to attack mine.
It's a really good three player. That is really cool because, yeah, I agree with
so
that. There are so,
wait, so
few good three players.
So
like, you know, there's often like three
inside.
Players that are like, oh, they can work as a three player, but usually it ends up being, you know, the whole kingmaker thing. You know, it's like two people end up going like this and kind of squashing one person, and one person's like, okay, I can either hurt this guy and then that guy will win, or hurt that guy and this guy will win.
Oh,
like,
crap.
I'm the worst person, but I've got the power of choosing who's going to win, and I don't think this is going to have that. Like, it might.
Wait,
I don't know. Have you found that?
Well, then I'm not going to flip them inside.
I don't think it
I'm
would
just
because
just like,
with how it works, it's like, I mean, you could. You could
well,
just get your
sucks.
Dudes and make every move to try and help one person win. But you'd kind of have to go from the beginning in order to actually help them.
Yeah,
so.
Well, movement after.
Conspiracy
after
before
yeah.
you
can 2v1, you know.
Conspiracy, everyone can hang up on this one person.
But even then, it's like, basically your best bet then is just keep your pieces out of the way of that person. At which point, you're just like saying, I'm just going to not participate. So, you know, it's a really good balance. I like
yeah.
I don't know, it works really great. I really like it. There's not much I could say
okay, so
that I think you should change. I think it's really sweet. Really sweet. Yeah.
So did you guys get a chance to see the turtle art over there?
No.
So this is obviously heavy and really nice,
yeah.
and I make
yeah.
them all by hand, but there's an option to get it with the turtles, and I think that helps people a little bit of like, okay, an egg can't push anything. And
yeah.
Yeah.
The only thing that was a little weird is like knowing where you're trying to go, because I kept on getting mixed up and thinking, I was wait, where am I supposed to go? Oh, I'm supposed to go over there.
Yeah.
So maybe having like
the printed board,
like some sort of like printed
stars.
Yes, cool.
So
that works.
Yeah.
Stars here, stars there.
And you start with no stars and you're going for some stars.
Great. That works. That's fine then. Just anything to say, hey, other than, because these are a little bit.
I also have another version of a leather where it's like lines on this side, lines on that side, hatch marks on this side, hatch marks on that side.
And
like, you know,
so,
yeah.
Oh, that this pattern, same pattern, the same pattern. Yeah.
That's also cool. Either that or just doing the outline of the triangle with the similar patterns. So, darkened on one, cross triangle on another.
Okay. Cool. Yeah, thanks for showing us.
If you want, I can scoot it over and you can try to
build it. Yes. You want to finish?
Sure. Well,
okay,
actually,
yeah.
I was going to get Huck Them Dice on.
Huck Them Dice.
So,
okay, so never mind.
I will say this. They're playing this over there, so if you want to get it on a new game.
Yeah, but I have one yellow.
Okay. Oh,
okay.
So I only get one yellow.
So, yeah. How long are you thinking for this?
About an hour. Try to give it an hour.
Are we doing this more of a explain or trying to get them to read the rules and figure out themselves?
Explain. Explain, help them
run through it.
Sorry.
Yeah.